focused on efforts in the rehabilitation of women migrant victim survivors of trafficking. And this is particularly in the experience of Batty Center for Women. Batty's is not an acronym, but it's a Tagalog word which means stream. And it's our tagline, a stream of hope and empowerment for women migrants and their families, especially the children of migrants, the transnational children and youth. However, for this afternoon, my presentation is just focused on the rehabilitation, as I mentioned earlier, of the women migrants. So who are the women migrants that we are working with? So initially, since Batty's was established in actually 1988, but just officially registered in 1989, in the early years of operation of Batty's, we're really catering those women returnees from Japan. But then in early 2000 and later, we also accommodated women returnees from other countries such as Taiwan, Hong Kong, Macau, Southeast Asian countries, and also women returnees from the Middle East, yung mga may red dots. And a few special cases of women returnees from Germany. And who are these women? Ano yung kanilang work categorization? So I think we all know that the labor outflow, overseas labor outflow of Filipinos, it's highly gendered, and women are usually channeled to highly feminized work categories, whereas the men in heavy production or construction work. So, as per the data of the POEA alone, when we look at the top 10 skills of deployment, nangunguna ang household service workers. Yung latest data ng POEA is 2015. Although data on there's no gender segregated data available, but I think we are all aware if we are to genderize household service workers, so we know that majority of them, if not all, are women. And pataas siya ng pataas. For 2014-2015 alone, 7.5% yung kanyang pagtaas. This is the data for new hires alone, and hindi pa kasali dito yung mga rehires. Sa Japan naman, most of the women are entertainers. So as you can see in the data, Filipino labor migration to Japan also is highly feminized. Kaya po na-establish ang Batty's in 1980s following the what they call is following the institutionalization of overseas labor in 1974. And talagang yung Filipino migration to Japan ay women ang karamihan. So when we look at the available data on the deployment of OFWs to Japan, ang dami talagang mga babae. And ano yung kanilang work categories? Female singers and dancers, or the so-called entertainers. So they comprise the majority. So mula early years until 2004, pataas ng pataas. But as you can see, in 2005 until later years, ay nagkaroon ng drastic decline. That was because of the strict implementation of Japan in their action plan to combat human trafficking in 2005. Because in 2004, Japan and the Philippines were both placed in the Tier 2 watch list of the U.S. Trafficking of State, Department of State Trafficking report. And so the government of Japan made efforts. So in the implementation of the action plan in 2005, there were restriction measures when it comes to the entry of Filipino entertainers to Japan. So nagkaroon ng decrees. But that doesn't mean nawala ng entertainers sa Japan because notably, pataas naman ng pataas ang Filipino-Japanese marriages. So, umusbong din the phenomenon of marriage in the context of trafficking.